Welcome back to the series of tutorials on keyboard shortcuts in BricsCAD. If you have missed the previous parts, please click on the link provided at the description section of this video. Let's continue with the application of control keys. Ctrl L can be used to toggle the ortho mode. I'll press Ctrl L, you can see that ortho is off. Now I'll press it again to turn on the ortho mode. When the ortho mode is on, the movement of the cursor is constrained in the horizontal and vertical directions. Now I'll draw a line in this direction, and you can see that the movement of the cursor is constrained along the horizontal axis. Now I'll pick a point here, and when I move it downwards, you can see that it is constrained along the vertical direction. Now I'll press Ctrl L to turn off the ortho. Now you can see that the cursor is moving freely in all directions. Ctrl M repeats the recently given command. I'll press Ctrl M. Now you can see the line command because that is the most recently given command. Ctrl N creates a new drawing. It actually invokes the new command. I'll press Ctrl N. Now you can choose a template and open a new drawing. Ctrl O invokes the open command. Now I'll press Ctrl O. You have got the open file dialog box. I'll select a file and give open to open an existing drawing file. Ctrl P invokes the print command. Now you have got the print dialog box and you can click on the print button to go for a printout. Ctrl Shift P toggles the display of properties panel. When you press Ctrl Shift P, you will get the properties panel, and when you press the same keys again, this panel will disappear. Ctrl Q quits the BricsCAD application and you will be prompted to save the changes. Ctrl R will let you iterate through viewports. Now you can see four viewports in the model space. Presently, the upper left viewport is the active viewport. I'll press Ctrl R. Now you can see that the upper right is the active one. I'll press Ctrl R again. Now lower left is the active viewport. Press Ctrl R again, and the lower right is the active viewport. Likewise, by pressing Ctrl R, you can iterate through viewports. Ctrl S invokes Qsave command and it saves the current drawing. I'll press Ctrl S. Now I've got a Save Drawing As dialog box because this drawing is not saved. I'll give a file name. Next time when you press Ctrl S, you won't be asked for the file name because you have already saved the drawing in a file name. Ctrl V paste the content of the clipboard. I'll select this dining table and I'll press Ctrl C to copy it to clipboard. Then I'll press Ctrl V to paste it. When you press Ctrl V, the software actually executes paste clip command. Ctrl Alt V invokes PasteSpec command and it will let you insert the contents of the clipboard in a specified format. I'll press Ctrl Alt V. Now you have got Paste Special dialog box. Here you have options to insert the contents of the clipboard as a picture, as a bitmap, as BricsCAD entities, or as a BricsCAD block. I'll choose bitmap and I'll give OK. Now you can see that the content of the clipboard is pasted as a bitmap or as an image. Ctrl X cuts the selection and puts into the clipboard. I'll select this dining table and press Ctrl X. Now the software invokes the CutClip command, and using Ctrl V, we can paste it on a convenient location in the current drawing or on any other drawing. Ctrl Y redoes the last action undone. It actually executes the redo command. For example, I'll select this table, then I'll scale it using the scale command, and I'll choose this particular center point as the base point, and I'll give a scale factor of 1.5 units. Next, I'll execute the undo command. If I press Ctrl Y, it redoes this operation. Ctrl Z undoes the last action. It actually invokes the undo command. I'll erase this table. Then I'll press Ctrl Z. which actually performs undo. Ctrl Home creates or opens the Start tab. It actually invokes the GoToStart command. I'll press Ctrl Home. Now you can see the Start tab, using which you can open a new drawing or you can open any of the recent drawings. Shift F2 toggles the display of command line. When you press Shift F2, the command line will get hidden. It actually invokes the command line hide command. When you press Shift F2 again, it brings back the command line and it actually executes the command line command. Shift F3 toggles the display of status bar. When you press Shift F3, the status bar will get hidden. When you press it again, the status bar will reappear. When you do this, you actually invoke the status bar command, which can take values 1 or 0, 1 for on state and 0 for off state. Shift F4 toggles the display of the scroll bar. When you press Shift F4, scroll bar will appear, and when you press it again, it'll disappear. The scroll bars can be used to pan a drawing file in the horizontal and in the vertical directions. When you do this, you actually invoke the scroll bar command, which can be in the on or in the off state. This completes the video tutorial on most of the frequently used keyboard shortcuts in BricsCAD. Thanks for your time.